Welcome to the 35th World Cross Country Championship. Welcome to Kenya. Welcome to Mombasa. Cross country running has finally come home. Running here is a way of life, but this is a land of contrast and of beauty. This golf course, the Mombasa Golf Course, has been converted to a world championship course with its twists and turns, and there's such an atmosphere here already. There really is. Well, the first race then, the junior women, that's about to start. It's over 6 kilometres, it's very, very hot, 27 countries, 86 starters, and Kenya very, very strong indeed. There'll be a big rush. Start until it settles down. Here we go then. First race underway, and the Kenyans, of course, the team champions from last season. And there'll be one or two, the Eritreans going out very strongly early on. And they'll need to, really, because it does narrow down as they get towards the first of the narrow gaps, and they've got a turn very shortly. So the principals will want to get out and away from the mass of the field to establish themselves. And I think we've got Kenyan presence right up at front as well. Yes, we have. The Kenyans all up there in front. 4.59 is there. And that's Wanjiru. 4.49. 4.59, Wanajiru is there, I've mentioned her before. 4.55 is there, Barasa, all the Kenyans up in that leading group. And so is Korekwiang. Now let me tell you that the first time they go through the finish, they'll have covered 720 metres, and then they'll have three laps to go, but the second lap will be a short lap, so if you've got your stopwatches operating, then it will be a lap of 1280 metres. Then they'll have a couple of laps to go, and each of those laps will be 2 kilometres. They really are pushing the pace on now. It's beginning to, and look at the spectators trying to keep up with them, and they can't get anywhere near them. Korekwiang on the left of your shot now. Barasa on the right. Koskai is there. 4.54, Koskai is there. Wanjiru is there. And this is once again Ethiopia, Kenya. It's a big battle between these two in the intense heat. Water being taken. Oh, she nearly went the wrong way actually there, did the defending champion. It is quite a complicated course this, but all of a sudden, Korekwiang, the defending champion, starts to motor. She really is flying now. And that's because she's coming down towards the finish again. Not the finish this time, but she's coming down towards the end of the lap. 13.31 the time, but look at the speed at which they are going. Oh, it's Kenya 1. Oh, this, it can't be. Surely that can't be. It must be. It must be the wind. I can't believe that. That looked to me as though there was another lap. There is another lap, surely, at 13.36. I'm not sure. Well, they certainly haven't done 2 laps of 2 kilometres, have they? They haven't done 2 laps of 2, unless it's my imagination. And I think they're moving, and there's some of them still going, and some thought they'd won. There is definitely 1 lap to go. My calculation, they couldn't possibly have done 6 kilometres in that speed, and that was a mistake. The Ethiopians were charging down, and off they go again. Well, that was an unbelievable situation. They thought they'd finished. There was a real charge for the finish. Well, Paul Turgat's again alongside me here. Paul, what do you reckon to that?
Honestly, this is incredible because, unfortunately, I don't understand how come that the kids were not given the sign so that they can able to know whether they are finishing or no. But my gee, this is a big mistake. And you see the young girls, they thought they already finished, and they still have a long way to go. I'm sure they're going to pay for this today.
Well, certainly. What about that? With down to 3, and they're all Kenyans now, and really, when you think about it, what the Ethiopians clearly misjudged it and ran that last lap so quickly to challenge the leading Kenyans. And all of a sudden, well, what a controversial start to this race. It really is. And I can't believe that. I really can't believe that.
now we are seeing the current Lynette Aparasa. She's leading now, and she's really keeping a shot because she knows now that she's going for a gold medal now, because it's a few meters to go from for this lap.
Well, what an extraordinary situation. I wonder if we can go a little bit further back in the field to see if Kore Kwiang actually continued, because remember, it's four to count in the team. So we've got to look to see. Now, is she there? No, 4.54. Let's see who is. Well, this is one of the Ethiopians. 4.01. Ah, that's Itta of Ethiopia, who really thought she'd finished. Here he is. Here's the defending champion. Now, she knows that she's got to run, Paul, because they're four to win the team event, and she's really got a motor. She's in desperate trouble. She really is.
You could see she's stopping. She's falling down. My, what's happening? She's a defending champion.
Oh, this is, we said that there would be problems, we thought, for the Europeans, but medical service needs to get to this young woman quickly. She is in desperate trouble, and now they've got to her. She's absolutely suffering from heat exhaustion, and that really is a sad, sad sight. A totally misjudged race, and lots of errors, but she's obviously panicked, tried to run too fast in this heat fall, and has allowed the rest to get away. But Lynette Barassa now moving away. What a situation.
I think when you do a certain kind of a misjudgment error, it's very difficult, especially once you thought you have won, and suddenly there's still a lap to go. You are fighting with the heat, you are fighting with the competition, you are fighting also mentally. So to be able to come up again, it will definitely take toll of the athletes. And that's what we are seeing now with the Kore Kwiang. She's out of the race. She has fallen because of the exhaustion of the heat.
Well, it also says a lot for the Kenyan team now. I just wonder which athlete will come through to make up the fourth place in the team. So it's going to be very interesting. The Ugandans were going strong early on, the Eritreans, but everyone's fallen away. And this is a magnificent run by Barassa, as she was fourth in the Kenyan trial for the juniors. But this is a very different performance.
Absolutely. As you said, you are very right, because what we are going to see now is whether whole Ethiopia, Kenya, Ethiopia are going to feel the first four that are supposed maybe to count for the team title. But I believe that maybe one of the Kenyans, the sixth and the fifth one, because Kore Kwiang threw it out, probably she's going to feel the rest. And the Ethiopians, it seems that we don't know whether maybe they are going to feel it also, because they made a very serious misjudgment error here.
I wonder whether it was because of that short lap, Paul, and that 720 metres to the finish the first time, and then the short lap. But I think she's coming in. We'll just leave off for the moment to greet this young woman who's going to be the world junior champion. And here she comes through to the finish now. And this is Lynette Barassa of Kenya. She's held together very, very well. She was up in that leading group, but not charging for the line. And this is a beautiful, beautiful moment for Kenya. It's come home, certainly. So while Lynette Barassa of Kenya is the world junior champion and coming through very, very strongly indeed. Behind her is Mercy Koskei of Kenya. Third last time, second this time. And that, there are some very, very tired young women coming through the line now. But my goodness me, what a story that race was. Third place, we've got 4.11, 4.59. 4.59 is at Wanijiru. She comes through to third place. So they're the first three. And that really is one of the unbelievably difficult races I've seen in cross-country history. We knew there were going to be problems. I think Itta came through. Dibaba, that's the younger sister of Tiranesh, just coming through, 4.02. 4.47. Well, that's another of the Kenyans, Chemweno. So the Kenyans have won the team. There's no question about that.
Yeah, absolutely. There's no question about that. I've seen that the Kenyan. And I believe also the Ethiopians are coming up strongly here. And Eritrean, 388. Eritrean, she's coming very strong. Moroccan also, 443. She's coming strongly there. And Ethiopians is coming up strongly again.
Well, they are really struggling here, and I am not surprised. They desperately need assistance at the end. There are cool baths at the end. There's Charlotte coming through. Charlotte Perdue of Great Britain coming through. She's run remarkably well, now being carried off. 4.21, Emily Pigeon is there through behind her, and that's a very good run for her. 4.01, that's Etta of Ethiopia coming through ahead of some of the rest, but a very good run by Charlotte Perdue. But let's have a look at this. This is the finish now. Paul, an exciting moment for the home crowd.
Absolutely, it is an exciting moment for the crowd. and congratulations for the Kenya. They have won 1, 2, 3, and they have won the team title. So what we are seeing here is, look at that magnificent finish from Lynette Barasa. She has actually won the race today. So thank you very much. I think what we are seeing here is that Ethiopians really done an incredible job, and they are finishing second in this team title.
Well, there it is. There's the confirmation. Very much slower. We thought it might be because of the heat, but Barasa of Kenya, well, an unusual winner. She wasn't expected to win this. Koskei in second, Wanjiru in third, so two of last year's medalists getting medals again. But they're the first three. Looking down the order, Dibaba, another Dibaba coming in fifth place. Look, Tirunush, younger sister, Bata of Eritrea. Then Chemweno of Kenya brings home the Kenyan quartet, and that gives them the team. Zeragesh of Eritrea, Mihari of Eritrea, coming through very, very strongly in the end. But that was tough. So the junior men's race about to get underway. 120 starters, 38 countries. And the conditions getting more difficult by the minute. The humidity, 80%. Temperature, well in advance of 30 degrees now. It's the heat of the afternoon. It's now 4:05 here in Mombasa. We're 3 hours on. And it really is very, very hot. You've seen the evidence from the previous race. So, the same situation as before. The first time they pass the finish, they've got 720 meters, and then a short lap of 1,280. Now, it confused us. And so it definitely confused the junior women. And now I just hope that these athletes will be able to take on board that the evidence of the first race. And all of a sudden, immediately, you've got a Kenyan presence in the first four. The first three are Kenyans, Martin. And one would expect these youngsters to be the future of the sport here.
Absolutely. The leader, number 160, Asbel Kiprop, middle distance background, this athlete, very promising, the Kenyan team. He's going to have to slow it down a bit, because he must respect the distance and the weather today, because as in the junior women's race, it wreaked havoc in the team placings and in individuals. Here come the Kenyans again, crossing the finish line off with the bell. And there's four Kenyans in the front, very exciting. I'm sure the crowd will really push them in this very last lap.
Yes, lap three gone, 18:20, 2,000 meters to go. Come on, Kizorio Kiprop, 18:24.5 the time. So, one lap to go. I think I heard the bell that time.
Oh, yes, yes, they didn't get it wrong this time.
No, that's right.
Come on, continues to apply pressure, and he's got like 2 meters on Kisorio.
Oh, this
the last
is a break.
Going.
Yeah, this
yes,
is a break.
This is it right here.
Yeah, Komon is really starting to move now.
Oh, yes. Second. Komon is leading, continues to lead. His experience now showing. Hope he can maintain that lead in his lap, but he's got three other compatriots right behind him. The break has definitely been made, and out of these four, we definitely will see a new champion this year.
Are you surprised in these conditions that the break was so early?
Yes, I am, but then again, I know with the experience that Komon has, that I think he's quite confident of his ability today, and let's hope he keeps it together, because as you know, these conditions are brutal. It can affect you at the very end, as we've seen some of the junior athletes coming through.
You know, when you look at this guy on the track, I mean, he's just outside 13 minutes for 5,000 metres, so he's world class, isn't he?
I mean, absolutely. I mean, 13:04 is a solid time. I think in the next couple of years, you'll see definitely sub-13 from this boy.
Well, he's only 19, and we talk about young athletes showing potential. Well, he's shown it and done it already, and he's looking very, very strong.
Very, very strong, absolutely. And the three others following him look very, very relaxed and confident, preserving those crucial team positions. I mean, this looks like a perfect sweep for Kenya if they can maintain it to the end.
Well, all of a sudden, the Ugandans dropped away, then the Eritreans dropped away, then the Ethiopians dropped away, which was a bit surprising, but all of a sudden there's a drink or a little bit of a spray with water. There is a water cannon over the far side of the course, I'm told, and they've got ice baths at the finish. But what a way for Kenya. The presenters, they've put together this championship brilliantly, they really have, and they're very friendly people here. 156 in second place, that's yeah. Chepkok in Chepkok, second place.
Yes, Chepkok won here in Mombasa and he's closed the gap already. He could be quite dangerous at the end, but do not forget Matthew Kisorio and Asbel Kiprop, the middle distance runner in this Kenyan team. He could be very fast at the end.
Just a glimpse there of the team situation, but Kenya 10 points. Well, that's perfect. Not bad, is it?
Absolutely. That's a perfect score. I mean,
four to count. Four to count.
Yeah. Absolutely. They ought to maintain this to the finish.
Well, it's anybody's race yet.
Absolutely.
I don't think that Mr. Vincent Chepkok is finished yet. He's best over 5,000 on the track. He's 13.17, but he's also got a pedigree over 10,000 as well, which gives him a base of strength endurance plus speed endurance. So he's got it all.
Definitely.
And they're closing down now. I yes. just wonder whether or not Mr. Coleman went off, despite his experience, whether he went off too early. It was just under 2,000 to go, you know.
Yes, I think he did go off too early because the rest of the group is back at him. And I think the most dangerous person here is Asbel Kiprop. He has brilliant, his devastating sprint, and he's now in second place, and he's tracking Vincent Kiprop, reminiscent of the national championship team Mombasa about a month ago. These two finished 1-2, so we could see a repeat of this performance again. Asbel looks so relaxed. I mean, look at that stride. I mean, yeah, he looks so confident and calm.
Well, Vincent Chepkok has taken it on, he really has, and this is now a race to the line, all the way to the line. They've now got half, they're right by the start, so they've got half of the golf course to cover now. They've got about half, in fact, they've got about 720 metres or a little bit less now to go to the
yes.
finish.
And Kisorio takes the lead now, is battling for Kiprop for the leading positions. Still not made much of a gap between Kiprop and both Kiprops, actually. So it's still not over yet.
No, you're quite right. 163, that's Kisorio. Mm-hmm. 156 is Chepkok. These three, it's down to these three at the moment. These three seem to have opened up a little bit of a gap now.
Yes.
Tall figure of Kiprop, Asbel Kiprop. 11th in their trials, doing a bit better here.
Oh, definitely. I think he was affected. I spoke to him after the trials. He was affected by the long grass and the Gong race course at the trials, but he's looking great today. Coleman has paid for it dearly for his yeah. move. He's back and forth now, about 20 meters behind these two. And these two are going at it. Again, reminiscent of the national championship. And it looks like Asbel Kiprop has moved to the lead.
Yes.
It's not significant yet, but he's got to take it all the way. Still looking sharp. Here they come again. Good chance. Kiprop has got it this time. He pulls away 5 meters from Vincent Kiprop, and he looks like he's got it if he can maintain it through the end. Tall, lanky Asbel Kiprop. He's got it this time. Looks very sharp. Asbel Kiprop with the lead, and here he comes. Last turn. Final turn, Asbel Kiprop, new World Junior Cross Country Champion.
Yes, he is, and Kiprop, who's paced it brilliantly, 11th in their championships, he's the World Junior Champion this time.
Fantastic.
And second place, Vincent Chepkok of Kenya. It's Kenya 1, it's Kenya 2, it's pretty quick too in these conditions, it really is. Chepkok in second place. And let's just make 163. Kisorio, he was their number one. He's in third place. The man who went off far too early. Come on, second last time, in fourth place this time. And that is the way it finished. And the next man home is Kiplagat, Benjamin Kiplagat. He's there, number 65 coming in. Now is Sibadu of Eritrea, 95, who featured for some considerable time. Is there, 71 is there. That's Sergei of Eritrea. But my goodness me, Kenya put on a real demonstration there. And I reckon Leonard Coleman of Kenya made a big error. It went off too early. It was just under 2,000 meters to go. This is a man who you know quite well, who's come in to win the gold medal.
Absolutely. I mean, Asbel pulled out the race of his life today to win. I mean, he got it right this time. Again, he finished second in the national championships here in Mombasa and lost a sprint to second place Vincent Kiprop. But he timed his run perfectly today, and he is the world junior champion.
Let's have a look at the result then. There it is, Kiprop of Kenya, 24 minutes and 7. Vincent Chepkop, Kenya, 24-12. Kizorio, Kenya, 24-23. Then Coleman, Kenya, 24-25. So that's a 1-2-3-4 for Kenya. So once again, the team goes to them. The team race goes to them. Well, let's just have a look then at the team situation. Kenya, a full house, 10 points. The lowest score counts, 1-2-3-4 in the race. Eritrea, once again, second over Ethiopia. The Ethiopians won't enjoy that. 44-54, not a lot in it, with Uganda in fourth place. The senior women up next then, four laps, 8 kilometres this time. They've got that 720 metres to the start line, or finish line, I should say. Then a short lap, and then some big laps. It's very much Kenya versus Ethiopia here. Tirunesh Dibaba, the twice champion, has won on the last two occasions, is here. And of course, it's a very, very strong field of Kenyans. And of course, there's also a Kenyan from the Netherlands who we mustn't forget. Kiplagat must not be forgotten. It's going to be a good race, this one, but the conditions may once again take their toll. So the women's race underway. 8 kilometres. The first visit to the finish line, just to remind you again, 720 metres. Then they've got the short lap. Then they've got two more laps after that. So it's a four-lap race. But with the start and the first lap is equivalent to one lap. One full 2,000-metre lap. So it's quite interesting, the way this course has been designed. It's very tight. Yes, it's fast. They've got bunkers to go through. With four laps, they'll have got through 36 bunkers. 36 bunkers in all. And I just wonder how the Kenyans will fare this time. But when you look at what the Ethiopians have got in strength, with Galeta Burka and Tirunesh Dibaba in particular, they've got Melkamu as well. It really is a very, very talented lineup indeed. 4:52 at the start of the race is Florence Kiplagat of Kenya. And the Kenyans, as always, will be up in that leading group, and so is the young woman we just featured, Lorna Kiplagat, in the wearing 4:83, who's representing the Netherlands. Tall figure. She should and could feature in this race without any question at all. Well, Ethiopia won the team event last year. Kenya second, Japan third, Australia fourth. But all of a sudden, the big three are there tagging on. Two laps to go, 4,000 metres to go. Halfway, in other words, so there's still a long way to go.
Yes, it's still a long way to go. And it seems that Lona Kiplangat, she's getting it right now here. She is, I think she must have made a very risky move, but it seems that it's paying off now. It's like there's a development gap, not significant, but it is building up, and she still look really very good. Look at how she's moving, and the legs is still coming up. So I believe if she's going to maintain that, then probably the day might be her.
Well, it might be, but there's still a long way to go, isn't there? Just over halfway, and it's, you know, 8,000 metres a long way. And in these conditions, but she's breaking away. She is getting, there's quite a significant gap now, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. The gap is building up now. And as I said again, the motivation for her now is that, remember, she's a marathon runner, and she has the endurance, unlike most of the other young the Ethiopians, which actually they have good speed, they are track runners. But with this kind of humidity, we never know. Oh, my. Okay, it's building up. It's building a huge cup now, and it's about 5 meters now, a cup.
I think it's probably bigger than that, Paul. I think the picture doesn't quite tell the story. I think it's probably nearer 20, but it's. I just wonder whether the Ethiopian trio are saying to themselves, look, she can't keep this sort of pace up. She's got this lap to go and one more. She can't keep this up, surely. And if we can make our way back to her slowly, then we can attack. But there are three of them, one of her. So if the three running together, that's a big advantage. And look at this. They're really trying to chase her now, as long as they don't do it too quickly.
Yeah, I think what's happening, they are coming up now. Dipapa, she's still lying third. But we want to see how it is going. But again, as the way things are, is that Lona Kiplagat, she's still strong. Hams is still bumping hard, and the legs are still high. That shows that she's still good.
Well, yes, indeed. There's no change thus far.
Absolutely, there's no change. It's really running smoothly now. And I'm sure she knows that it is only 1.5 laps to go now.
Well, looks to be relaxed in the face. She will know, she'll be told how far they are behind. There is a big screen to our left, and I guess the athletes might be able to look up at that to see where they are. I'm not sure, it depends what picture we're on, but that margin is not changing too much yet. For the trailing group, Melkamu is leading it, and then second place, or third place rather, is Burka, then Dibaba, happy to sit on the back. But has Kiplagat done enough to get away from this absolutely scintillating trio of Ethiopians? But look at that. Now, is that a telltale? Look over the shoulder. I wonder. 6 seconds the gap? Well, look at that. That's not a lot, but it could be significant. She is moving beautifully. You're quite right.
Of course, this is really a very risky, calculated move that she has taken. But again, it seems that it's going to pay off. It is interesting to see Kelete Burika and Parika and Dibaba. All of them are coming up. But again, as you said, it is the way Lona Kiplagat is running. She's comfortable and she's doing really a lot of damage now. I want to say that it seems the weather really has taken toll of many, many established athletes and renowned athletes in this championship. And we never know now when it will, when, look at us, she was looking behind us. But you see, nobody's actually behind us. So she's comfortably looking to go and win. And she's coming forward. She's not far from where we are now.
Well, she's only got about 500 meters to go. That's the crossing over from the field in which the start is. And the start is 720, so we reckon she's got about 500 meters to go, less than that now. So that will give her a new lease of life. And on this final lap, she's coming away to be the world cross-country champion. And that really is quite something. Very, very
interesting to watch this. Yeah. Lona Kiplagat has finally delivered a gold medal for Holland, Holland, and I think this is going to be something. For the first time, Holland has had an incredible performance here.
Yes, it's the first one for the Dutch, and it's in the hands of a former Kenyan, a Dutch woman from the July the 23rd, 2003. Very popular over here, as Paul was saying, from her village. Absolutely superb. And she'll soon be closing in on the finish and into the straight now. She looks very, very strong. Look at the crowd looking up at the board, looking up to see her, and they're all waving now, her supporters, as she comes through in towards the finish now. It's a very, very fine run. The flag, she has such an advantage now. A wonderful, wonderful moment.
Absolutely, look at it, that's incredible. She's all has a lot of energy, and now that she's waving, she has a flag, and she knows that she's home, and she's obviously last one.
So Lona Kiplagat of the Netherlands is the world champion. Looks untroubled, has not been troubled as many have today. 26 minutes and 23 her time, and that was a wonderful one. Now then, here we go. Who's going to take this? Dibaba relying on that sprint finish, or is it going to be Melkamu? Dibaba again uses that sprint finish. Dibaba is second, Melkamu is third, and Burka in fourth place. And that really was Burka coming over the line. Wondered what on earth happened in the final stages. She was the one that missed the medals. But it was once again a Kenyan, but in the strip of the Netherlands, who comes home. Lona Kiplagat of the Netherlands takes it from last year's winner, the winner for the last two seasons, Tirunish Dibaba, who really didn't get into the race here, with Melkamu of Ethiopia in third. 4:52 is Florence Kiplagat, the top Kenyan, coming in next. Florence Kiplagat has done well. The Kenyans have bunched well for the team. We'll see where the leading or the fourth Ethiopian comes. 4:40, 4:48. That's a Chepchumba. She's home. 4:57 is Chapleting of Kenya. She's the more experienced of that group. Well, at the end of it all, it was a Kenyan wearing the colours of Holland, a villager here to celebrate this wonderful World Championship win. Lorna Kiplagat of the Netherlands is the world champion on the country for 2007. 26:23 a time, but the times don't matter. It's the manner in which she ran. Absolutely superb run, it really was. Let's just have a look at the result of that race. Let's just give it a formality. Lorna Kiplagat, 26:23. Tirunish Dibaba, 26:47. Closed down in the end, but Melkamu, 26:48. Burka, in fourth place. Then Kiplagat, Chumba, Ngich. Ethiopia with three in that first four. Well, actually, here we go. Ethiopia did win it with 19. Kenya, look, didn't quite get there with 26. In second place, Morocco in third, Spain fourth, a very good performance by Great Britain, fifth in the team with 140, ahead of Australia, ahead of Eritrea, which is a very good run by the Europeans. Well, this is the big one, the senior men, six laps, 12 kilometres, Kenenisa Bekele going for his sixth consecutive win in these championships. It really is going to be a battle. It's getting a little bit cooler. There are a lot of competitors, 165. There are 45 countries represented here. And once again, it should be between Kenya, Ethiopia, and Eritrea. That's how it's gone in the past. Let's see how it goes today. But the conditions, once again, may take their toll. It's been a difficult day for all the athletes. The men's race underway. 12 kilometres. 165 competitors, 45 countries, the defending champion, the defending team champions, Kenya, Eritrea got the silver last time, Ethiopia with Kenenisa Bekele at the helm really will want to do something different. Now, what will the Kenyans do? What will they try and do? Bekele's already up in that leading group, and I just wonder how this, will the Kenyans sacrifice someone? Will someone be sacrificed for this? I don't know. 169 is Richard Matalong. Now he's a steeplechaser, and Matalong, 169, a steeplechaser coming to the country here. He was third in the trials, so, and he's taken on, and Bekele's gone to the front all at the beginning. Now is he going to, there's a good point that Martin Kaino made about did he see what the women's race, did he see what Lorna Kiplagat did, and will he do the same? And that is interesting. Look at him, he looks so easy. I know it's the start, Paul, but this is a different kind of athlete.
Yeah, absolutely. What Bekele we have seen now, it is not unusual for him to be able maybe to fast, maybe 500 meters to come into front. But again, as I said again, he's very motivated to start this race and probably to stay with the front runners and make sure that for any eventualities, he should be able maybe to be in front and control. Look at him. He's actually going in front and he wants to control the race from the front, because once he's there, he's actually going to create more of intimidation to other athletes. But I want to assure you that Bekele is the man to watch here, and as the race, Matalong is here. It is a great, we have athletes from Qatar, they are here also. I think it will be very interesting to see how this race is going to develop. This leading group, it's interesting again. It's still a very big group, close to about 15 athletes in front.
I think that may well change soon, but Kenya are leading the team event. At the last time they passed through the finish line, they've got the little monitors on their ankles, which gives us a clear indication of who's who. Now, what was that from Bekele? Was he asking for drink?
No, I think...
Or was he wanting someone else to lead?
No, I think somebody was actually pushing one another here, and then they were thinking that probably Macharin Yang, thinking that... Bekele is pushing him, and that is why. Let's see, he's coming up. Ngetun, that is Bekele. Tinkeza is there, and Kiprop from Uganda.
Yeah, he is. He's still there, isn't he, Kiprop? And Kiprop, of course, is the Commonwealth champion at 10,000 meters. So He's been there or thereabouts. They all know Bekele, and they all challenge him at this stage of the race, but it's what happened. Oh, there's a faller now. Who's that? It's one of the Qatar athletes, and he's absolutely down and out, isn't he? Number 60 by the look of it. That's Kifle, Jonas. Oh, it's the Eritrean. Well, that will hurt their team, certainly. That's Kifle, I think, at number 60. He's gone down.
That was really a very unfortunate because somebody tripped and somebody has fallen down here. And I think somebody has been working so hard for such a long time, and see his chances is going to smoke now.
Let's have a look at this.
Look at that.
There, actually, he tripped. The Qatar athlete was tripped, didn't go down, and then he tripped on one of the Qatar athletes.
Yes. Oh,
that was totally unfortunate.
Very unfortunate. Now Jonas Kivler is out.
He's gone. So that may hurt their team event with 6-2 go. Remember, they got the silver medal in the team last time ahead of Ethiopia. Now it's beginning to break up. I just wonder what Bekele was saying. He was unhappy about something. He was remonstrating with one or two. I don't know whether they were nudging him or too close to him or what. But there he is, wearing 89 on the left. 172 is Edwin Soy of Kenya. Second in the World Athletics Final. That was after the championships. That was in the 3 and 5,000 metres. That was the end of season races last year. But let's have a look at this. Now, what's that all about, do you reckon, Paul? What are we... Is he saying that Edwin Soyn is barging him too close to him? What's he saying?
I think probably there might have been somebody elbowed one another here, and somebody was saying, hey, please take care of, you should not make me to fall down, something like that.
Yep, it's competitive in every sense of the word out there, isn't it?
Absolutely. Look at now, the race is changing now. Komletadese from Eritrea is in front. Bekele is gone, he's in front. Keep Mosov, Kenyan national winner champion, is sitting third now, and it is interesting. It's the problem. Kiprov sitting on fourth. Chepkrui is sitting on fifth. The race has actually changed from here.
Yeah, you're right. Let's have a look at this. Tadesse Eritrea is there. He's coming through to lead up this with three laps to go. 17:58 gone. 6:06. That was quicker, that last lap. It was about 20 seconds quicker.
Absolutely. I think this is where the race actually is decided here. Tadesse is gone. I mean, Tadesse and Bekele is gone. There's a huge gap coming in between the first lead, the first two, and the third second group.
But this is where the battle is. 12 seconds. Well, Mossop actually is hanging on quite well here. There's still more than a lap to go, so really, it's hanging on brilliantly. I have to say, one of the innovations where one has the big screen at the far end where all the people can look, it's a huge screen where everyone can see our pictures and can follow the race, and that's really good. That's very good. There are, I should think, there are between 10, 15,000 people just surrounding the course itself. The road is packed to the right of us and to the far distance into the field beyond, watching one of the greats of all time. Now then, is this it? Is this Kenenisa Bekele now? Has he gone? I think he might have gone. This is the hurt. This is the point at which he said, right, I am going to be the champion for the sixth time. I'm away, and it looks as... Zezene Tadesse of Eritrea may be under pressure eventually from Moses Mossop, because there's only 12 seconds, and I just wonder whether the penalty he pays with staying with Bekele for so long and leading for so long may take its toll.
Yeah, the race is gone between Bekele and Tadesse. Bekele has actually decided now, this is it. This is it. This is a breaking moment. Decided to go for its sixth straight title here in Mombasa, Kenya.
Yes, it'll be the most titles ever won here if he achieves this, but it looks as though he is. And Paul Turgot sitting next to me has won five. John Ngugi has won five. And he really is something else. 27 cross-country races unbeaten. He only announced on March the 5th that he changed his mind about skipping the championship. Decided to compete in Mombasa. I would think his national governing body might have put a bit of pressure on him to come here. But this is a moment of history. It's not just going to be six wins, it's going to be six in a row. He seems to be gesturing eyes. He's look. I don't know whether he's looking for a particular bottle. Ah, there he are. Just wants a little bit of refreshment. Even he's finding it hot. But my goodness me, the pace at which he's running now, he's burned off to Desi, who's dropping back now. Look at that. That's a significant... Oh, actually, I didn't see him behind those alleys. Not as far back as I thought. But he is dropping back a little bit. And I just want to see if Moses Mossop, where he is on that, Ben. I think he's a little bit further back.
Yeah, Bekele, as I call it, destroyed everybody now here, and he's absolutely running superbly here in Mombasa. He's going for his
he's slowing.
Something is wrong.
Sorry?
Something is wrong.
Something is wrong. You're
going.
Right.
He's slowing.
He doesn't look comfortable.
He doesn't look comfortable.
No, he doesn't. We've got one lap to go, or whether he fancies Tedesi taking the lead again so he can run off him, but he didn't look that well. This is very interesting. Now, what about that, Paul? What do you think looking at that?
It seems that there's something wrong. Probably the problem with water that he took now that he's taking it is building up stomach cramps. I'm not sure. No, he looked good. He looked brilliant.
Well, look at this.
But
Tedesi
seems that he's putting pressure. That's a problem. He's not pushing anymore. Look at the hands.
Yes.
Look at the arm.
You're right. He's not, is he?
He's not himself.
Happy to sit
look at the eyes. There's something wrong.
Yeah. I think you're right. He's got 54 bunkers to have run through over the course here, and that's not easy. But Tedesi must be encouraged by this.
Absolutely. He's motivated now.
Now he's going again.
No, he's going. He's going out.
Well, this is extraordinary. It looked just... I'm not sure he got his balance around that corner. I'm not sure what he's doing here, but this is getting very interesting. We're into the last lap now.
Let's wait and see what's happening. But he look good. He look okay now. I thought there was a problem before. But I think Zachary regained his composure, and I think he look good. But that is it. That is good. There's a problem.
Yes, there is.
There's a problem.
Yeah, there is a problem.
Bekele is having a big problem.
Yes,
the rest is gone.
Well, this
is gone.
This is a big story now. It looks as though
Kenenisa Bekele is gone.
Well, what about this? The first time in history he'll have been beaten if he can't get back to Tedesi.
He can't. The legs can't move now. I think there was a problem with the water. He had a major problem because this is very unusual. This is not Bekele that we know. But again, the Tedesi is taking advantage of the situation and is moving, he's blowing away now. And just a few meters to go now.
Yeah, he's well into the last lap now, and that is the most significant gap. And Tedesi Bekele, Kenenisa Bekele is beaten, I think. Look at that, there's a look of resolution. He's resolved, he's finished.
There's a problem. It seems that he might even collapse here, because if you could see even the highs, there's a problem. It must be the hydration is taking toll of him now.
Yeah, I just wonder whether Moses Mossop can see him. I wonder whether Mossop can see him. Well, there's the advantage. Here's your winner, leader rather, Tedesi. Well, I wonder what Tedesi must have thought then.
I'm sure he had already given up initially before, but again, once at this stage, nobody can ever, maybe if you are actually feeling good, you cannot let the race at this hour. So there's a problem with Bekele today. I'm sure the weather has taken a big toll of him today.
Look at this, the Eritrean.
Eritrean here has been very consistent for many years now. I think his day has come, and he's going to take this one home. It is few meters to go now, and I think we are expecting him in the next few meters from here.
Well, the Olympic 10,000 meters bronze medalist, he was their first Olympic bronze medalist, their first Olympic medalist, and this is going to be a wonderful day for him to beat the likes of Kenenisa Bekele of Ethiopia, who'd won five times, and your record, Paul, looks as though it's going to be equaled only. Five wins in this championship, and it doesn't look as though Bekele is going to advance on that. And you're quite right, he might not finish the way he looked.
It looked really bad.
Oh! Tedesi looked behind him and almost went through a post. It's very tight, the turns here. This is full of events, isn't it?
Bekele is finished.
He's finished. He's gone.
He's finished.
I thought he might not.
Oh, this is the race between Akolia and David. Things have changed here. Bekele is gone.
Yes, he's gone.
Bekele is gone.
Well, there's a cheering here. Obviously, they are supporting the Kenyans, and one can understand that. But they've all seen the big screen, and that's pretty unkind for a champion. But Eritrea, he nearly went for a post as well. This is an unbelievable race. What an unbelievable day of events in cross-country running.
It's incredible. It's incredible to watch this race here in Mombasa. 2007 Mombasa World Cross Country Championship has developed into a race that's unthinkable. Nobody believed that was going to be like this. Kenenisa Bekele is out of the race.
Yeah, and the conditions have got to him. Quite clearly, something's wrong. The conditions may well have got to him, and it's just one of those days, isn't it? And Eritrea, who really lost the... who beat Ethiopian in the team event last year, have got a very, very strong position here with first place because the Eritrean looks good.
Yeah, Eritrea now is coming a few meters, is finishing the race. Tatesa is looking good.
Oh, he's looking brilliant, and he's got a look of determination on his face now. Not far to go before he'll turn left into the home straight. And this is a man who really came here and didn't read the script. Bekele goes away with medical help, but this fella churning on. You were quite right, Paul, he was in trouble, and in the end he didn't finish, and we thought he might not. But
yeah.
This is a fantastic individual run at the end. He must have thought when Bekele tried to go that he was gone, that Bekele was away, but not this time. And this is a new champion now, and this is Zezene Tadesi of Eritrea coming through to be the world cross-country champion. Just under 36 minutes. Look at this, what a way to finish, a brilliant run. He is the champion. Tadesi has not read the script, he's been knocked over at the finish. He won't worry about that, and he says that is brilliant. He'll forget about that. They were too quick to him, they almost knocked him over. Now then, Kenya coming through. Yes, they are. Kenya, it's Moses Mossop.
Yes, Moses Mossop has finished second. Kenya national champion has actually taken advantage of the weather and the drop out of Kenenisa Bekele. It is interesting here that, as I said again, Mombasa, we were expecting any changes here, any surprises was going to power to happen here in Mombasa, and it has really happened today. Tata Bekele is out of the race. A new champion in World Cross Country Championship was actually born here in the name of Tadesse from Eritrea.
Bernard Kipchego is there. So is Ngatuni is there. 167 Matarinyang is there. Kenya surely have won the team event again.
Yeah, they have won a team title in a big match here.
Well, Kekele, there's the man at the moment. That's a good run in by Kipyego. Well done, sir. 162. Bernard Kipyego, or rather, Mike Kipyego. Bernard's already in, of course. What an event for race, Paul. I mean, what can you say? And look at this. Another Kenyan comes in. But really, that was full of incident. Absolutely full of it. 172 coming in. That's Edwin Soy. He's there. 289. Looking down the field is Turicic of Uganda. There is the man who says, waves to the crowd, thank you very much, it wasn't my day. He didn't finish. It's sad that he didn't finish in a way, but he looked near to collapse, didn't he? Going back, these are the scenes of a man, the first Olympic medalist in Athens, an Eritrean, a big smile, Zezene Tadesi of Eritrea, comes in to be champion of the world. Wonderful, wonderful moments. Some didn't survive the day and had to be carried off to be revived. But there is such a celebration at the finish. The Kenyans are surrounding their team. Look at this. What an atmosphere here, the Kenyan support. And what a moment for this man from Eritrea. That was one of the great days of cross-country running. I don't think I've been so excited for a long, long time. So much happened in those races. There's the confirmation of the result. Zezene Tedesi of Eritrea, 35.50 the time. Let's forget the times, they're insignificant. Moses Mossop of Kenya, the silver medal. Then Bernard Kipyego of Kenya, the bronze. That's two medals for the Kenyans. Kenya in fourth, Kenya in fifth, Kenya in sixth, Kenya in Ethiopia in seventh. The first six, one, two, three, four, five. One more Kenyan, Soy in ninth. That says to me that Kenya are the champions of the world once again. Well, there's the team standing then from that senior men's championship. Kenya 29, Morocco in second, 151. Then Uganda, Eritrea fourth with 209. What a day of cross-country running. What a world championship it was. Full of incident, full of drama. In the heat of the day, Kenya were the junior women's gold, silver and bronze medalists and the team winners too, despite the demise of last year's winner and favourite, Pauline Korikwian, who failed to finish. For the junior men, it was a 1, 2, 3 and 4 for the Kenyans. Well, they were led home by Aspel Kiprop, but what a team effort for them. The senior women's race was dominated by Lorna Kiplagat, a Kenyan now residing in Holland. She destroyed twice winner Terunesh Dibaba. It really was a very, very good race, and what a demonstration. The real drama, though, came in the men's senior race. The great Kenenisa Bekele was beaten at last by the conditions and by a brilliant Eritrean, Zezene Tedesi. He added the world championship gold to the bronze medal he won in the Olympic 10,000 metres. That was Eritrea's first ever Olympic medal, which he won in Athens in 2004. But all in all, as far as the team results go, it was Kenya's day. They won three out of the four categories. Only the women's senior race and gold medal got away. So from Paul Turgat, from Martin Kaino, and from me, Stuart Story, from Mombasa, goodbye.